Hi, I'm Tara Milo, and today I want to talk about words I don't hate. I know it's really fun to talk about words we hate, but I'm going to flip that and talk about words I don't hate. One of those words is manifest. I know people throw around the word manifest as if it's easy, but they know that there's a little more work to it, and there's some depth to that word that they're going to explain to you later. But people love to hate the word manifest. I don't hate it. I love it. It's fun. I have manifested some pretty awesome things. Another one is abundance. People love to hate the word abundance. Maybe it feels vague, or maybe it's another one that people feel like is thrown around too much without given a lot of meaning. But I love the word abundance, and I love to manifest abundance. So those are some words I don't hate. Here's another one. This one's been popping up recently. Girl boss and lady boss. I don't hate the words girl boss and lady boss. I actually call myself computer girl because the word girl to me means light and fun. It adds a little playfulness to my business. It makes me accessible. And the same with lady boss. Like, we all have a girl inside us. We're all a little bit like a lady, and we're all bosses. So let's just love all these parts of ourselves and parts of each other and be supportive of the inner child, the little girl in somebody else's business, and the lady in somebody else's business. Let's support each other and not hate these words. Sometimes they're important words to somebody's business, and not just mine, other people too. Here's another one. Lead as in subscriber. Some people don't like the word lead because a lead is a fellow human being who has signed up for your email list so that you can deliver value to their lives. We know that, but that's a really long sentence. So let's cut it short and call them a lead or a subscriber. We know they're valued. We love our subscribers and our leads and all of that. It's just an easy word to say in place of that big long sentence with all the touchy-feely stuff. Okay, here's another one that people love to hate. It's the word boot camp. People love to hate the word boot camp. I don't use the word boot camp, but I don't hate it either. You know, that's an important word for some people's business, you know? And I'm actually in a boot camp that's all about manifesting abundance, and I freaking love it. Speaking of freaking, a lot of people swear. I don't swear. I don't hate it when people swear. I don't think it is, you know, unprofessional. I don't think it's dirty. I don't think it's masculine. I don't think any of that stuff. I think you love to swear. Swear. Do it. It's fine. It's cool. I don't hate that. I don't do it myself, but I don't hate it when other people do it either. Can I throw a couple more at you? How about sales and marketing? Let me tell you, I love the word marketing. Marketing is sexy and powerful, and sales are what make us a business. If you're not making sales, you're not a business. So you gotta have sales, and the way you do that is through marketing. They're just words that we use to symbolize the bigger activity of our business, right? Okay, that's my list. Those are some of the words that I don't hate. I'm sure there's other words I don't hate. I'm not gonna tell you the words that I do hate because they're your words and I want you to use them. It's none of my business if you use the words that I hate. You use the words that you love and you're going to attract people to your circle who resonate with those words. So please use them. Hey, tell me in the comments below, what are some words that you don't hate? Words that you see people picking on sometimes and calling out in posts? What are the words that you don't hate that other people do? Let's unhate some of these words. Post them in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video.